gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The crowds asked John the Baptist, "What should we do?" He said to them in reply, "Whoever has two cloaks should share with the person who has none. And whoever has food should do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they said to him, "Teacher, what should we do?" And he answered them, "Stop collecting more than what is prescribed." Soldiers also asked him, "And what is it that we should do?" He told them, "Do not practice extortion. Do not falsely accuse anyone. And be satisfied with your wages." Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, "I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In Latin, this third Sunday of Advent is known as Gaudete Sunday. Gaudete means rejoicing. We hear references in our scripture readings today to rejoicing. We are about halfway through the season of Advent, and so our anticipation begins to build up. And what we're building up for is to celebrate the anniversary of Jesus' first coming here on earth, while joyfully anticipating his second coming. Unfortunately, a number of people have maybe grown up and been taught in a wrong way, either by teachers or by parents, that the end of time is something to be feared. That God is angry, and when God comes back, he's just going to destroy everything. That's simply not the case. And it certainly isn't what the scriptures tell us. The scriptures call for us to be waiting in joyful anticipation, to rejoice, because the Lord is coming back on this earth again. And so this Advent season is a season that reminds us that every day we are Advent people, that every day we are preparing in some way or another for the coming of the Lord, whether it be before our death or after our death. Now there's something natural, I think, in all of us that wants to fear what is somewhat unknown to us, because we're taking all this by faith, and our faith allows us to believe this is absolutely true. But at the same time, our human minds start thinking, well, what if something else is going to happen? What if there is going to be all this pain and destruction? But the Lord is coming back in joy. He's coming back to gather up his faithful people and to join his faithful people at that time to all the faithful people beginning from the beginning of time to rejoice with him, to be happy with him forever in heaven. The gospel today we hear again from our parish's patron saint, St. John the Baptist. John was Jesus' cousin, and his role was to prepare the way of the Lord. Prepare the way of the Lord. And he was doing that by a baptism for the repentance of sins. But also when asked what the people should do, he gave them advice on how to prepare for the coming of the Lord. Basically, he said, you need to be generous people. If you have two cloaks and somebody else has none, give them one. If you have food and nobody else, and someone else has no food, share your food with them. Treat people justly. Treat people with respect. Treat people as God has told us they are. All of us made in the image and likeness of God. That is how we rejoice. And that is how we prepare for the second coming of Christ. Which this whole first part of Advent has been all about. Preparing for the second coming of the Lord. Reminding us that it is a lifelong process that we are doing. So today is Gaudete Sunday. Today is Rejoicing Sunday. Today is the day that we are reminded. Our faith is mainly and predominantly about joy. Doesn't mean we're not going to have difficult times, we're not going to have painful times. Ultimately, our faith is about joy, because our faith is about God.